you want me to look like this,
I want
right?
to look at me.
Ah, you want me like
yeah,
this?
Yeah, okay. Trying to ignore this whole
thing. Okay. At school, when we started to discuss gravitation, that changed my whole life in some sense. I was first set to become an architect, and I was very keen. I did already internship even at building sites and was very enthusiastic about it. And then we had in physics, very late actually, I think in the last year, we started to discuss gravitation, and that was it. So I was so fascinated, I simply changed all my plans. I mean, I found out when I started studying that there were very few women. In fact, in physics, it's even less. There are fewer women than there are in mathematics. So, and when you start, you feel a little bit, oh, maybe I don't fit in that well because they're mainly men. But especially during my PhD and later on, I always, I was very, very lucky. I worked with people where it really didn't matter at all. Perhaps maybe once in a while you get a snarky comment or you. But I think I never had a disadvantage really. I would say there it's an exciting thing. You have a lot of teamwork, collaborations. You go and visit. You have you give seminars. You start talking to people with different interests. So I would say that this picture we have that we are locked up in a little room without a window and we have a piece of paper and a pencil that has certainly changed. It's hard to tell really what I try to achieve is really to the research I believe in. The physics which I'm interested in. I hope that the project I'm working on will push them a little bit further. I believe there's great value in what I'm doing, and I hope that the work we're doing will also convince others that this is the case.